Hello, and welcome to Let's Read the Books of Baldur's Gate. I am Amethyst Lunatari. Today I'll be reading History of Arm, which I found here in a commoner's house by a small pond in Olgoth's Beard. History of Arm. Arm has the good fortune to have abundant natural resources. Some would say Arm is the richest land on the continent. This has worked in Arm's favor for generations, because even if they were conquered, the new masters would be gentle, looking to gain wealth from the land rather than to put it to the torch. Arm has been a center of trade and commerce for as long as anyone can remember. Oral traditions handed down from father to son tend to support the theory that Arm has been a trade center for at least 800 years. Unfortunately, written records are difficult to find and often incomplete. It would seem the typical Omnian citizen was too busy trying to fill their coffers to write down events of the day. Arm has always been more interested in the present and the future than the past, and this makes an accurate history difficult. The best records, the business papers of the oldest trading companies, are jealously guarded. The fear of revealing trade secrets is stronger than the call of history, so the average citizen knows very little about Arm's past. It appears that the Arm of 100 years ago was very much like the Kalimshan of today. Each major city was basically an independent entity, banding together for defense when necessary and fighting for control of territory and profitable trade routes the rest of the time. A particularly brutal trade war began 24 years ago, with each city extracting prohibitive tariffs on goods imported from the others. The trade war escalated, and city troops began to raid caravans sponsored by other cities. In a matter of months, commerce was brought to a halt, a number of cities were under siege, and war threatened to engulf the entire region. Into the breach stepped a young merchant named Thais Selimchant. Thais was smart, charismatic, and very well connected. The Selimchant trading house was one of the oldest and richest in Athcatla. He secretly contacted representatives of the 5 other richest merchant houses in Arm and started to plan. The first part of the plan involved the careful sprinkling of rumors about outside threats. One involved a pirate invasion from the Nalanther, another was about amassing of orcs just on the other side of the Cloud Peaks. Thais even started a rumor about an elf army in the forest of Tethir, ready to pounce on a divided Arm. None of the rumors were true, but they began to turn people's thoughts toward unity, not war. Thais knew that if he and the other members of his council were to take control of Arm, they would need broad-based popular support. Tensions between cities and merchant houses were still high, so to get that support, Selimchant and the others agreed to drop their family names and never use them again. When news of a council of 6 spread throughout the land, many people accepted their rule. A group that would unite Arm under one rule, governing for the benefit of all, instead of one city or trading company over another, was indeed a welcome change. The council raised an army, at great personal expense, to quell the few pockets of resistance that remained, and have been in total control of Arm for the past 22 years. Thank you for listening to Let's Read the Books of Baldur's Gate, History of Arm.